Next one, when we talk about services, as I said, service is an act or performance that one party can offer to another that is essentially intangible and does not result in the ownership of anything. Its production may or may not tie up to the physical product. As I said, its production may or may not tie up with the physical product. It means you have to just encash on how best you can deliver this to the customer by way of creating more and more innovative way of presenting it. For example, I remember whenever I talk about this characteristic of service and I am talking about intangibility and perishability, it always comes in mind one of the best example like multiplex. Many times you have seen the peak period or the peak time for watching movies is only Saturday and Sunday, or sometime it is Friday. So what this owners of different multiplex, they are doing, they are keeping various offer on the non-peak days like Monday to Wednesday or Thursday if anyone is going in a particular non-peak period, like from morning 10 to 12 or 1 or in the morning time, they will be provided with a free refreshment. So when we talk about encashing on perishability as one of the important characteristics, you have to think the various way how you can increase the utilization of your service or your product by coming up with various tie-ups. Like as I said, if you are using so and so bank credit card or debit card for refilling your petrol or maybe purchasing some product, you will be getting a cash points or reward points. So that is nothing but tying up your product with some particular service. Okay. Next, this is the difference which I have just explained you, that product is tangible, service is intangible. Product can be stocked in a particular godown, but service cannot. There's a reason we say customer do not participate in the production process. In services, when we talk about service, they are not participating in product, they are participating. Okay, how in services they are participating in the production process? Like for example, when I talk, I am delivering this lecture. This is nothing but this is one form of service. Here you have to listen whatever I am telling. You cannot store it, but yeah, if it is recorded, you can reuse it as per your convenience. But many times when we talk about service cannot be stored, it is if a particular flight have to take off and in that out of 100 seat, only 50 seats are being sold, 50 not being sold, but still the takeoff need to take place. That's the reason we have to say that you have to improve the way how you are delivering the service so that more and more customer can buy your product and service and you can get maximum profit in that particular interval. Next one, the above mentioned characteristic do not apply in equal measure to all services. Some services are highly intangible, like education. Just now I said highly intangible. You need to consume it as and when it is produced. Okay, next one, others are highly tangibles, like fast food. Fast food is also, now there is a dispute going on whether fast food comes in the service industry or it is coming in the product industry. So now I'll be taking one particular continuum where you will understand that still fast food is being taken between product and service, because you can see for, you can have it, that's the reason it is one form of product, but the way it is being delivered by various restaurant and hotel, it is coming as a part of services also. Next one, some may be highly variable, for example dental treatment, various clinics are providing various benefit and the treatment, the faster you are getting, it is going to work for you, you will be going to particular dentist or a doctor. Next one, some highly standardized, for example automatic car wash. And last one, it helps in terms of designing to understand how these marketing can be used in terms of increasing the efficiency of various products. So how different actually are service? There is no clear cut difference between product and service as Levitt have suggested. There are no such thing as service industry. There are only industry whose service components are greater or lesser than those of the other industry, or everybody is in service. So basically there is no specific difference that this is the service I am marketing, this is the product I am marketing. Basically all are doing one job, that is they are serving the market. That's the reason you have to understand the importance of how serving the market can be improved by way of providing innovative ways in making the product or service available to the customer. So if the absolute tangible and intangible elements are taken at two ends of a continuum, it will be observed that all goods and service occupy different position in the continuum. So just have a look on this continuum. As we can see, the continuum shows that there are two ends. One is in a form of pure products, which are purely tangibles and these are homogeneous. Wherever you will go, you will find a similar product. For example, I can buy a mineral water from a particular place, and the other place also I go, I can get the same brand. But when I talk of services, it is heterogeneous from brand, that is from bank to bank. Last one, you can see highly intangible is teaching. So as you can see over here, food outlets, that is fast food outlets, there is still the dispute going on whether it is only a part of product or it is a part of service. So it is basically a mix of both. Why? Because as I said, restaurants are providing foods which is purely visible, but it need to depend on how innovatively you are delivering these products in a very cool environment, that is ambience, people and process. So now that will be the next thing what I'll be talking about is how services can be differentiated. So basically it is a survection process which need to be understood by the marketeer. What is that survection process? It is being said that this word is a combination of service and production, indicating the simultaneous production and consumption of service. As I said, simultaneous production and consumption of service, delivering lecture, production, consumption, immediately you are hearing and you are taking the understanding of various topics. In general, the survection process differ from a production process of a tangible goods in the following respect: interaction between the front office personnel and the client. So when we talk about a service is a survection process, that means it is a combination of two things, service and a process. Just remember the core pillar of a difference between product and services. Service is intangible, it is inseparable, it is heterogeneous, and it is highly perishable. When we talk about the difference between, what is the difference between how a market can be managed? So you have to just remember four important things, that a market can be managed by way of analyzing what is the customer demand, their needs, then planning it accordingly, how and when we can provide. And next one is how we will be implementing, means launching this product at right time so that the right benefit can be understood. And lastly, but not the least, controlling the entire process by way of CRM. So the next is how the marketing of financial services can take place. Basically, marketing strategy provides the organization with a sustainable competitive advantage in the market as and when it is possible. So what are the various type of financial service that is available which need to be marketed? Number one, the credit market, that is the loan and so on. The money which is being taken in a form of RD, your saving account, current account. Next one, the money market, the equity and long-term debt market. Then insurance market, foreign exchange market, mutual fund, stock market and customer finance. So basically these are various way how you can market your product. So as we were talking about bank marketing, what are the various things as a bank marketer we need to understand? It provides service, aim to satisfy customer needs and wants. Needs and wants may be non-financial in nature. Competitive element, that is in the form of efficiency and effectiveness. And what are the core objectives of any bank? Number one, the objective can be in a form of commercial objective, that is earning profit or gaining revenue. And next one is the social objective. So essential for the banks in terms of getting success is cannot exist without customer, create, win and keep customer, organizational design should be oriented to the customer, deliver total satisfaction to the customer, and last one, customer satisfaction is affected by the performance of all the personnel who are working in a particular bank. So that gives the base for the next thing, that is how we can increase the efficiency of our bank by incorporating various marketing mix. So basically marketing is going to depend on four important pillars of marketing mix, which is also known as the key element of marketing mix. What are the key elements? So we say these key elements are nothing but the key concept of marketing, that is product, price, place and promotion. What are the product and service? All the banking product and service, as I said, in a form of credit market, money market, debt market, then your insurance market, these are the financial product that need to be marketed. Price, how I can keep different pricing factor for marketing these product. Pricing is very core term, but it is purely governed and ruled by some of the authorities of our country, as you all know. But still, pricing can vary in a form of what type of transaction cost I am going to put on the transaction conducted by my customer, what type of interest I am going to put if they are not, or the penalty I am going to ask for if they are not paying their due in time. Next one, promotion. That means how I'll be promoting my product. As you have seen, many times banks are coming up with an offers like, if you are depositing so and so amount by so and so period, you will be getting a benefit of interest rate, like 10% interest rate for a particular fixed deposit. So there are various promotion activity that is being conducted to tell you about what type of benefit senior citizens are going to get if they are taking the services from a bank, students are going to get if they are taking a service from a particular bank. So these are various way how they are promoting. Next, place. Place is nothing but it is in a form of branch offices, head offices and so on. So most of your transaction, even opening account and so on, you are going to use your branch offices so that you can provide the service to the customer. So basically, the marketing is being divided into two lessons which need to be learned, that is the old P's and the new P's. When we talk about old P's, it is nothing but the four important P's of marketing mix: product, price, promotion and place, which is being replaced by four new C's. We are not only talking about product, it is said, we need to also understand about who are our consumer. Consumer means our customer, what they want, in what manner they want, how I can make this product available to my customer. Next one, we are not talking about only the price that we need to charge on our customer, but we need to understand the cost, that how much cost it is going to take in terms of developing the service and providing it to the customer. Many times you have seen, you people are discussing about if we are going to install so many ATMs and so much is the cost that is going to be increased. So can we put these costs in a form of penalizing our customer and so on. So basically you have to understand what cost is going to take place in terms of implementation and whether it is directly dependent on the usage or indirectly. So you have to understand the cost as one of the most important parameter. Place, how many places do you need to have your branch offices? How easily the access can be provided to the customer by way of your ATMs and so on. Next one is promotion. That means what are the various way I can use to communicate about my product and place to the customer. It can be in a form of advertisement, print media, hoardings, in a form of various billboards, or maybe in a form of sales promotion. Like many times you have seen in Diwali, they are coming up. You can exchange, you can stock your gold at our place and you will be getting some credit based on it. So what are the various way of sales promotion you are using, at what occasion you are using and how it is being provided to your customer. Now, the four P's till now I was talking about, it is purely about using these four P's and C's for product, to some extent to service. But when we talk about services, three more extended P's are being added, and that is people, process and physical evidence. Now, what does three extended P mean? People means you are providing a particular service to the customer, for which you need a very trained and efficient staff who can communicate the service to the customer the moment they approach you. Process, what type of system and efficiency you are using to deliver this product? Are you technologically advanced to make your process very strong and deliver it? Many times you have seen HDFC Bank coming up with a promo like 40% faster withdrawal. What is this? They are talking about their process, that so efficient their process is. Like SBI coming up, providing the maximum benefit by way of faster withdrawal, or very quickly the fund transfer can take place. So you are coming up with various way of showing people and creating an interest that how efficiently they can get this service from a particular bank. Next one is process. Process, people and physical evidence. Now that's the most important P again. Physical evidence means the moment I enter in a bank, what I feel. I feel how differentiated they are in terms of handling you as a customer, in terms of delivering that product to you. So basically they are providing the service in a form of physical evidence. You know SBI by their logo, you know Punjab National Bank by the infrastructure and the logo. So these are physical evidence which help you in differentiate the one bank to the other bank. So based on people, process and physical evidence, you can create a differentiation. You can add the mix of other four P's also, like creating a very strong promotion campaign to tell your customer, these are the product we are marketing and we are providing you, and these are the benefit you are going to gain. So basically we will be talking about four more C's which is being provided, that is cost, communication, convenience and customer, and which is also being added by four more A's, that is when we talk about product, it is also the acceptability of the product which need to be understood by the customer, how well they are accepting it, Affordability means whether they can, it's not only the cost and the pricing factor, but even affordability, whether they can afford my product. They can come up with so much of deposit many times because of affordability. Many of the banks have came up with an offer 0%, that is zero balance account. Okay, so that is nothing but affordability, also one of the criteria. People want to have an account, but they don't want to have a minimum balance criteria. Next one is accessibility, that is your place. How quickly I can access my account. And last one is awareness. What are the various awareness campaigns used by your bank to educate your customer about your product and service? So basically, what is marketing? Marketing is a mix of all 7 P's. What are the 7 P's now? Product, price, place, promotion, people, process, and physical evidence. So this form the base for marketing. With this, the next thing what we need to understand is what are the various type of marketing. So there are basically many type of marketing the marketeers have came up, and it can be applied. It's not required we will be applying all, but some which is relevant to our industry. One is holistic marketing. What is holistic marketing? It means you need to conduct a marketing process which is a combination of internal marketing. Internal marketing means the functioning of your 4 P's. Integrated marketing means the functioning of your communication, PR and advertising department. Performance marketing means how well you are performing as a brand in a given market to increase the brand value of your product, like the way you are known in the market as a brand, or the awareness level, or the sales revenue the brand is building for you, and even different community. Like example, when I talk about tell any 5 public sector banks, so whether my bank name is coming in that 5, if yes, that means you have a very high recall for your product. And the last one that will come in holistic marketing is relationship marketing. How strong you are in maintaining the CRM for your company. That is, there are 4 things that will come in holistic marketing to make your bank one of the successful bank is internal marketing, then integrated marketing that talks about the communication, performance marketing, and relationship marketing, that is your CRM. If we are combining all these 4 functionality, we will get a holistic marketing which will provide the very strong base for our bank performance. Next one is relationship marketing. It is purely an CRM department that is handled by your organization that consists of customer, employees, marketing partners, and financial communities. Like for example, many banks are coming up with various tie-up, like ICICI coming up with a tie-up with HSBC, then some other bank is coming up with a tie-up with an MNC bank to provide a wide range of service to their customer at various place and location. Next one, integrated marketing. As I said, the marketing of various communication mix. Next one, they are talking about internal marketing, internal performance, and last one is how well you are using your marketing mix for selling your product. So basically, when we talk about marketing, it is consisting of understanding about what are the various process being a marketing management you need to follow, that is analyzing, planning, then implementing and controlling. Next thing, what is the difference between product and service? So you have to differentiate the service on the basis of services intangible, inseparable, heterogeneous and perishable. Next thing what you have to understand is what are the 4 P's. It is product, price, promotion and place. Last thing what you have to understand is what are the 3 extended P's of service marketing. It is people, process and physical evidence. And applying these all concepts, you have to understand what is holistic marketing for an organization. It is the combination of all the 7 P's. So with that, we will be completing with our unit 34, and the next unit will be talking about what is customer and environment.